They just have to be better with the football on this possession.
So the last, that didn't bother you too much last time?
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. Another try after the first down sack. Murray. He'll let this go deep for Ryan.
You bitch, you knew that he fucking was faster. I read that. I just not fast, bro. Oh, he's too fast. Diggs too fast. Or not Diggs. Ruggs is too fast.
It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2.
That was Sanders, too. He isn't in for speed. Fuck. Your ass. My type hit.
It's a pretty good return here as they get this up to the 29.
The Bills take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They had the interception last drive, led to the tying touchdown, so 7-7 the score as they begin first and 10. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs.
That's my type of hit.
Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. From the gun, it's Wilson. Flushed out right. He'll try and run it. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Looking to throw again on second down. Wilson. The attempt on the dive, and he has it. What a catch. Now the Bills will use the second of their timeouts as the stoppage will come with 23 seconds to go till halftime.
First and 10 at the 26-yard line.
Throwing down. Wilson on first down. He gets this one into the hands of Dalvin Cook. The Bills are going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they'll stop it with 17 seconds to go in this first half of action. They only got a yard out of that last completion, and that makes this second and 9. From the shotgun.
No, I didn't mean that.
Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Picked up by the linebacker, Corey Littleton.
I knew you were just going to stay mid because you were in zone. Oh, shit.
What is going on here? Are they serious? First down, and they're in punt formation.
How the fuck do you pull? Never mind.
Well, the white flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it.
No way.
Take a knee here.
This defense is really pulling in the first half. They've gotten to the ball carrier before they can really get started. Offense got to come up with something in order to try and get this running game going.
So a touchdown apiece. That's what we have to show at halftime as they head to the line.
That's no fun.
7-hour score. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with
Jeff. Oh, it's just fun.
EA Sports halftime report. Coach.
Yeah, we're playing for like the MCS.
Here for his trouble of bringing it out of the end zone as he's down at the 27. Buffalo offense ready to go for their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. 2 possessions, 2 turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think
he caught it.
Not even necessarily to my best player.
That's my top.
I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
So Charles,
I beat her Dooney's down.
Keys as we continue to play this second half.
Now, I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case,
I thought I could outsmart the AI.
Defensively right there, because you've always got to be aware that he can take off and make a big play with his legs. How about the way they were able to contain him? That also tells me the coverage was excellent downfield.
He is going to find Hill here. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. He was held without a catch in the first half, but he's got one here, and he also picks up a first down. Wilson. And now he'll tuck it and run. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
A gain of two. Brings up second.
Here's Wilson. Buying time to his left.
Throw it away! Black fog!
He goes.
A loss of 12 brings up third down.
Third and long, it's Wilson. Being chased out left. That'll be complete to Cook.
Why did you go backwards?
I'll go for it. I don't really care.
That's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
The offense staying out there. They look prepared to go here on 4th and 10. Flush to his right.
Imagine. What kind of throw is that, Wilson?
And that'll be incomplete as it's knocked away.
Let's go.
The flag is dead.
He ran in the third.
So who's this going to be on?
Yo, but look. Look to the flag.
There's Wilson to throw. His throw caught right at the 6. He gets into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. A 22-yard touchdown grab. And the Bills have taken the lead. And on that one, able to catch it, also able to have the wherewithal to take it in for the score.
Successful catch and a completion of a play. Look the ball in, secure the catch, and then of course the run after.
Oh, I know. But you interfered with his pass to the ball. And then why is it a flag?
Returning it, Johnson. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And this game was all square at halftime, but now they find themselves down 7 following the opening drive touchdown here in the third quarter.
And they need to take a good, relaxing, deep breath, don't you think? Because right now they might start to feel like they've got to play catch-up here and start matching them point for point. But it's still too early to get there. They can still run their offense. Plenty of time to get back to this game.
It's caught out on the left side. Taken down, but able to slip across the 35. First down yardage on the first play of the drive, 14 yards.
Oh.
He will be hit from behind and run over. Wow. Off the edge, Jerry Hughes gets the sack. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. Throwing is Murray on third down. Got a man and he hits him in stride. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Back now in Buffalo. It's the Packers who have the football, but in need of points as we begin quarter number 4. On 1st and 10, here's Murray. Looking left side, he's
going to check down to that tight end about 50 times.
Not quite to the 30, he'll be down at the 31-yard line. To throw again on second down. Murray escaping the pressure right. And he will not get the connection there. It's incomplete.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
And he's got the first as they'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. 3 yards there, good enough to keep the drive moving. Now Murray.
He had yet to run the ball at all on this drive, but 3rd and short, definitely was.
And time finally runs out. He can't get
Joe Bosa.
Ball and he's taken down. Joey Bosa getting him once again, his 3rd sack of the afternoon. Play action. Now it's Murray.
Going for it all. I know.
Oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Robert Alford.
All about it. Get the football back. I will push.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. Dancing to his left. And he just gets rid of it. Throws it away. A wise move there. Looked like nobody open. Now second down. After the incompletion, here's second and 10 from the 20.
Good fucking Dalvin is now.
Try and wind down some clock with Cook. And he'll get only a couple up.
How about Allen?
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here to have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Eluding the pressure right.
No, throw the ball, you stupid fuck! Adolf Rey, just remember. I don't care if I win or I'm playing this game for fun. I'm playing this game for fun, bro. I just don't care enough, like.
So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. And here's a big one now. Try to hold this lead. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Flushed out right.
Oh, you stupid fuck. Well, do you know why Wilson threw it to the left instead of just Waller right there?
Picked up by the linebacker, Corey Littleton. Well, this is one heck of an individual performance we're witnessing. That is now his third interception. And keep in mind, folks, this isn't a safety or a cornerback. This is a linebacker.
Why is it this play? What the fuck?
Like he's having a flashback, because a lot of these linebackers we see in the NFL, in high school they were offensive stars. They touched the football all the time.
Because that always happens to me. It's like they're wide open.
Put on the letter jacket and go get the football. How about this one? Three interceptions thus far.
I'm playing three.
Previous run good for nine. Here's second and a yard. Again, it's Cook. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
And a pretty little juke move there on a nice gain. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one. Brings up a second and one. On the carry, it's Cook. He's able to work it here to the 8-yard line. That play gets him 6 yards and sets them up with a first and goal.
I'm all surprised right here. They've got 3 timeouts left. The clock's running down, and they aren't using them. Those timeouts do you no good at home. Use them now.
And he maneuvers his way down to the 3-yard line. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. Back to throw, Murray, forced out to his left, and he is across and in for the score, and now they can tie the game in the final stages with the extra point.
Or they can go for two and go for the win, and while it appears the heavy was accomplished by scoring the touchdown, they're still down one. That extra point is not a gimme.
17 seconds and a
extra point, it's up and good. We may very well be headed to overtime. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. They'd like to avoid overtime here, so maybe they can work the sidelines, but then defensively, how do they adjust to that if they do work the sideline?
It's the old leverage game, and we usually talk about leverage at the line of scrimmage, right? Who's going to win with the low blocking and everything that goes along with that. But in this case, you're trying as a defender to leverage them towards the middle of the field, not let them get to the sidelines.
I did not mean
tackle them inbounds in order to run the clock out.
Chess wanted to know. They'll operate from the 32-yard line here, second and three. Play action. Now Wilson. And complete right side to Cook. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out.
What you thinking?
6 yards to pick up, and that's a first down. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Throwing now is Wilson. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off near the 44. And his guys will take over at their own 44-yard line. Good starting field position for him as they come up first and 10.
I hope he went. For the fucking Cardinals.
After the turnover, here's Murray. And the Bills are going to get him as he goes down. And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams
get
field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving
team fucking know how to defend on
six or fumbles the ball and gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They're set for their first drive here in overtime, and this is where the crowd can really become a factor.
They've had to battle it all day, but I know what you're saying. In overtime, that gets doubled, doesn't it? At least, because now the crowd really wants to be involved and help their team. And that first drive can dictate the whole thing, because they know if this team takes it downfield and scores a touchdown, it's game over.
It's been loud in here so far. It's a first down on a gain of 10. Oh. A 10th carry in the game for Cook. He'll take this from the 40 up to the 45 for a gain of 5. The first down run got 5. Here's second and 5. Now Cook. Pushing forward for 3 up to the 48. Hoping to keep this OT drive alive. Now they face a 3rd and 2. They'll run it. Here's Cook. And he's got enough for the first across midfield to the 48. So 1st and 10 now in Buffalo territory at the 48-yard line. They run Cook. They've had some success here in overtime with this opening drive running the football right back to that well.
And why not? When you have that kind of success, make them stop you. And until they do, keep going back to that well you just spoke about. I think there's more water there available to them.
2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead them to 3rd down. First throw of overtime for Murray.
Give me that. Fucking give me that, baby. I read that. I don't know what
you don't usually get a chance to throw a second one. I mean, I'm not sure the analytics on it. Let's ask Marvin, our statistician, to ring that down for us. That's typically how coaches
feel about it. Yeah, because you were being a bitch running the ball, so I didn't do the same thing.
And his kick is absolutely perfect. And the Bills will take a 3-0 lead. We were just treated to an absolute dandy in this one. A great.
And you're in the ball. Why second?
Field goal, everybody, including us, on the edge of their seats. Quite a game.
And it's rare that you get a game into overtime that it doesn't turn out to
Bills
be a game.
Bills McNeil.
That's what we saw here. And just what you were talking about, a long field goal to win it. So definitely not a gimme. So there was tension all the way through.
Really?
Through the
post. But it did go through the post. Ice water was in his veins. That'll do it.
I used to that.
For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gunn. This has been Madden Ultimate Team on EA Sports. Join the discussion on Twitter.
I didn't even leave my PlayStation on like 2 hours.
U-T. Yeah. With that, we say so long from Buffalo.
My phone's updating right now. It's taking long enough. The Wolf Squads. Right. Now, because I don't play Mud Squads. You're more than welcome. Now remember, you only need one game to see if your players are good or not. So now you just gotta work on your team. Yeah.
You gotta work on your team. Let me know when you're done, Joe. Bro, another Chandler style burger with hay right now. That's what I'm checking into. what is there? Oh, there's none they can wear in Ultimate Team right now anymore. Oh, yeah, that shit's good. Yeah, dude, I want the pro. Resets in 25 days, bruh. Oh wait, no, never mind. Alright, Gilbert.